Let's get started on this. I think this should be my new ritual, is cleaning the screen. I'm going to start doing this to put myself in the drawing mood. This little ritual here, just wiping down the screen and making sure it's been properly cleaned. Getting some Windex on there. How does this thing even get dirty? I don't know how that happens. And yet it does. Somehow. Anyway. Back to the old grind of the Gart. Let's get her pulled up on here. And I think I want to concentrate exclusively on the hands and the rest of the body over here. And I want to think about this more. I want to think about how exactly I want this to come out and how I want it to come across. And I think what I actually need here is some reference. So let me look up some images like this. I kind of look around here. It would be ideal to find someone in kind of a thick shirt holding it up. But I will take whatever I can find. Okay, that's not bad. I'm really not seeing much of anything here. I should actually go and start up the stream. Jump in the voice channel and do the screen share. There we go. Let's take that live. Okay. Really not finding anything that looks like I want this to look. Nobody's lifting the shirt high enough. Or they're not lifting it with both hands. That's the other issue that I'm finding is it's mostly people lifting the shirt with one hand on one side. I am not finding good reference for this at all. I'm not getting anything that has the look I'm going for. Doesn't have to be a girl. I'm looking mostly for the wrinkle effect, so it doesn't actually matter the gender of the person lifting the shirt. Well, this is producing much better results. What if I specify a sweatshirt? Do I get a, I get a good picture of someone lifting a thicker fabric. I'm getting shopping results for sweatshirts with slogans about lifting weights. So, I'm going to try changing it to man holding sweatshirt up. This is really not getting me better results either. What about man taking off sweatshirt? Yeah, I know this is really helpful and useful that I'm just kind of looking for reference. But, I don't know, maybe this is helpful in seeing what the process of looking for reference looks like. Yeah, most of these are not sweatshirts. I don't know what the... Most of these are dress shirts. It's not a sweatshirt. No, that's not very helpful. Okay. Okay. All right. All right. All right. So. We want to do then. Let's concentrate on this. We want to switch down to our line art layer and using our eraser, we want to pull some of these. Let's drop the composition layer down a bit. Okay, so take that out. I'll take that out. I'll try to do more of a cute cat's paw sort of look. I'm some test, and that's way too big. And we want it in black, so. Let's erase those vectors there. Now we've got top of the, we've got a sort of a, come down into our color layer, grab this color and fill in the space. And now we want to look into the shading layer and kinda give that some depth there. And I think in the line art layer, we want to specify that a little more. And we want the same general kind of thing over here. But this space, let's get that in there. Let's see what we've got in terms of look so far. Pull that bit. Now we need to pull that on the line art layer there. Then we go back to color, go back to brush. And there's that. And we want to have, well, we want knuckle. Right? How's that look? I'm not liking that. How's that look? I don't like that last one. Come into our shading, grab that color, shade the side of that finger, and the side of that finger, the side of that finger, and a little bit in there. And how's that looking? I think we cover this part up a little with drag that down like so. Yeah. We go to our color layer and we clean that up a little bit, and we go back to our line art layer, move our composition copy back where it belongs. Back in our line art layer, we're gonna clean up this little bit here. I did look for some reference, but I didn't find any. So we're gonna work with that, and now we're gonna take this up, and we're going to take the airbrush in this color, and we're going to raise up the size of that. Come over to here and we'll fill in this space. This needs to be regular brush. And that also needs to be regular brush right there and right there. And we'll come back to the airbrush for there, and we gotta clean up this bit over here rather substantially. This is just, that's sloppy as hell. And just kind of did sort of a scribbly sketchy thing to put that in place, but what we actually want is a kind of okay, we need to pull those, pull all of that. And that can be simplified in there. In fact, I want to pull most of this except just the silhouette. And the brush, we're going to go this, going to hang down. A lot of crap in there. Pull this up. Okay, so I'm going to come down here. And actually, let's, take this bit here, drop it down, and then we'll come from behind that. Notice that that doesn't look right. Should have an outward sweep like that. And we'll bring it across here. This squared off elbow is more typical of a man. So we want to demasculinize that particular joint there. Come off to the side, we're going to come down. Come off to the side, down here. And then here. Come down like that. Now this isn't, this needs to come out further. then there's that. And then here's some crap that's not in the right place. Let's clean that up. We'll clean that up. Trim that. Redraw that. And there. And okay. This is starting to shape up, but I want this to have a sort of symmetrical quality. So, back to our eraser, we're going to pull that and that. We're going to pull all of this crap here. And then I want to sweep over to the side there. Sweep down here, and then I want to sweep up around there. Back to our eraser, we're going to pull that and that. Pull that. And we want kind of a creasy bit there. And a creasy bit there. If we're going to do a creasy bit there, then there's a creasy bit, and there's another little area. So that's that, and okay, now get some color in here. Similarly, we're going to come down around here. We're going to grab this. We're going to go down around this space right here. And now back to our airbrush so that we can clean that edge up and that edge up. And we'll put a little gradient on that bit. And we'll go back to our line art over here. And get back down to 8, and we'll go back to black. And we're going to kind of do a little interweaving there. Yeah, there we go. Control 0, turn off our composition and see what we got here. All right, and back on our line art layer, I want to bring that up. I'll scooch in, grab the flesh tone, and I'll clean the edge along that line. And since she's holding this up, it's going to cast a bit of a shadow. So let's go into our shading and we'll in fact, now I think about it, this is the perfect application for the old anime lines running down the face thing. So if I am in here, I want to see how I feel about this. If I go to the brush and I want the lines very thin, and they should be on the line art, and they should be black, and they should be this is probably an effect that we have on monochromatic patterns, manga materials, mosaic, messy, jaggy curve, vibration, announcement. Seems like something they would have. There's a red blush. And what is this? Let's drag that in and see what we got. Okay. So what I want to do with this is, let's go to our quick access, go to scale rotate, and bring that in like that, and then we'll move it into the appropriate location. This is, in fact, precisely the kind of texture I'm looking for. I just want it to be much finer, much closer together. And we want that to... Can I get a piece of this that sits in the right location? I don't think I can. Yeah, I don't think that's gonna work. Let's just delete that layer. Okay. So yeah, let's just not do that. We'll come in here and blend on our shading layer. And that's really just kind of disappearing, isn't it? Yeah. That's about the best I can do there. Let's go back to Vector Eraser, Line Art. Pull that, and pull that. Pull that. Back to our color, and we'll... push in here to fix that. Back to our shading, and we'll put shadow over here. Which we will then blend. we got a shadow there. We're also going to need a shadow down here. Line art to clean up there and there and there. So the line art, let's go to black. Clean that up. Go to the shading. Grab this color again. Use a slightly larger brush. And we'll blend that in. We'll switch to transparent so we can clear up this color outside of the line art here. Again, slightly larger brush. That back there, and need this white bit here to come all the way down. That's all the way down the edge, and that means we need the airbrush come in right along there. Okay, no, that needs to needs to be wider. And now we'll go to the airbrush and we'll fuzz out that border. Zoom in on that. Clean up outside of line here using the brush, not the airbrush. Line art, clean up there. Clean up there. 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 And we want to work in black, of course. Back to our color layer. Clean this up. Right in there. Clean that up right in there. And now into the shading layer, because this needs to be much darker, and we'll blend that. Okay, skin tone, color. Brush. Oh, what the hell? Do not save. Brush. We'll clean this bit up here. must be here. So back out and kind of look at that. This bit here, line art. Is going with color layer. Line art. Brush. Black. Brush. Color layer. Okay, so given that this is where it is, and I'm on the wrong layer. There we go, color. That where it belongs, and that where it belongs. Clean things up a little here. Clean things up a little here. A little bit here. Got some sloppy line art here. Back into the color. Back to the brush. Transparent. Let's get next to the line there. I'm not terribly happy with the way this bit is going, but it is about the best it can be. Given both tools I have at my disposal and the skill level that I am working with. I'm not working with the greatest skill level here. I am not good at this. Let's see if we can work out some way to so we're going to stick with color. We're going to come up here to white, and we're going to try to sort of stay white, like bright white. And some sheen to it. Maybe if I blend that a little bit, that'll work fine. I'm gonna tone that down a bit. And draw a bit over here. Make sure when you do this that you're following the contours of the body so it actually looks like it's on the body and not just scribbled up there. Not like this helps excessively. Okay, and now let's switch over to transparent. And we'll clean up around the edges a bit. And I need to pull some of this line art here. Because it's in the way. And we need to add a bit more line art. Then go back to the brush, back to the color layer. Brush, I said, not the paint bucket. That would be a disaster. And I think we're doing okay on that. I think that looks about like we want it to look. Down here, I think we need to jump into our line art and clean up that little bit of the tail. Back to our color. Clean up that and that. This part here. Come into this space and remove that. Make sure we finish out that area. There's some of this skin to it around the side. And, clean up these vectors here. Black. That. Clean up that little stray bit. Let's see what we're looking at now. Definitely better. Brush, color layer, get the skin tone back in here where it belongs. That white put back. Skin tone there, and we need in the shading layer a shadow under the arm, right in there. Another one there. And we'll clear that space out and we'll clean that up a little. We'll go to our blender and just kind of drag that down. Get just a little something going on there. See what we're looking at. Definite progress. More work to do still. Always more work to do still. Okay. So a shading layer, so let's grab the color of the tail there. Carve it back and smooth it somewhat. Now we hit blend, and blend that out. For the same basic thing here, we want a little sort of I want to get our little Y in there. Okay, stretch out there. Drag that out. Blend that in there, blend that in there, and that in there. Now we'll, in here, clean up clean up this space. On the color layer. Clean up over in there. And over in here. Some of that is on the shading layer, so let's clean that up. Some of it's still on the color layer, so we'll clean that up. Line art layer, a little bit of mess to clean up. There we are. Back to our color layer. Fill that in there, fill that in there. Back to our color layer, I said. Shading layer needs to be toned up there. And color layer needs to be toned up there. Clean that up there. I'm cleaning up the wrong layer. Back to the shading layer. Blend. We'll blend in the shading there. Blend in the shading there. Color layer, black. Clean that up, clean that up. And okay. All right, the next thing we have to work on is the legs, and I don't want to work on the legs tonight. We are closing up on an hour, so I'm going to go ahead and call it at this point. And let's have a look. Okay. I'm reasonably happy with that. I want to clean up a little of the line art right here. Let's go ahead and grab that line art. We're going to pull that. We're going to pull that and that. On black. There's the... Right, so... Put that in. And then again, just clear that up a bit, and then we'll grab that, go back to color, and to brush. And then we'll put that in. And there should be a shadow underneath of the clothing here. There should definitely be shadow there. Let me go to blending. We'll blend that in. I'm gonna pull that out. And we are definitely getting somewhere. I don't like these little bits here poking out the side. Let's pull those. And go instead to color, we'll clean that up, erase that little bit there. Let's see what we got. Shading. That bit right there. We need shading here and here. Pull out on that, and now we're looking pretty good. Okay. That, I think, can be it for tonight. And let me grab a quick screenshot. So that's out. Okay, and well, that'll be that. So let me just remind you once again, do a little YouTube dance, like, comment, subscribe, all of that garbage. I have so much respect for the YouTube process, I swear. But yeah, hit the little bell notification icon, all of that. Also, they just gave me access to the community tab. I don't know why. I'll try not to get it taken away by being a jerk, but who knows what is going to happen. Anyway, that's where we are. Thank you for being here. You're much appreciated. Every single one of you that watches, I appreciate all of you. And okay, bye.